Today we're doing the timing belt on a 4.7. This is a Sequoia 2000. Yeah, it's got a pretty bad engine squeak from one of the belts. And I removed the serpentine belt and started the engine to see if it was timing belt related. Unfortunately, it is not, which means that I'll have to replace a couple other things. But I'll walk you through the whole timing belt process, as well as the thermostat and all of that garbage. So Cornelius and I are going to show you what's up, and Pierre Luc is he's still here. He's hanging out. So here we go. So I already removed the serpentine belt, which would go on that top pulley right there, and basically there's the tensioner pulley right dead center of your screen. It's a 14 millimeter bolt that you can put a wrench onto or a socket, and basically you'll push down and to the left if you're standing in front of the engine. And that will relieve tension on the belt, and then you can just pull it right out across all of the pulleys. I'm gonna disconnect the battery since we'll be messing with a couple electrical connectors, and I'll take off the air box and the tube, or not the box, but the tube and everything, get all that garbage out of the way, and we'll be home free. Alright, I'm gonna drain the radiator, which on, depending on what vehicle you have with this engine, it might be on the other side, what kind of radiator, but on the Sequoia, it's on the driver's side, or the left hand. I am not gonna be reusing this coolant, so dirty Napa bucket. And to increase flow rate up top, there we go. Thank you. don't have a fan clutch tool. 12 millimeter wrench and pry bar will get the job done. Just hold the wrench on the last of the four nuts and use a pry bar to push, basically push against the fan clutch to keep it from rotating. Clutch would not pop off of the fan bracket there. So, bigger hammer, bigger screwdriver. The fan clutch and the fan bracket pulley had rusted in place together, so I wound up having to use the classic method of wood shims, big hammer, and a screwdriver in order to get that thing out. Right on. We're gonna do a little bit of pulley ASMR here. First we'll try the fan bracket. This is with 200,000 miles on it. I'll see what's up with the idler. Does not sound too good. And last, our tensioner pulley. Seems to stick a little bit. So I'm going to be replacing all three of those. Thank you. All right, where did we leave off here? Got to get the tensioner, power steering pump, and alternator off and out of the way. Then we can tackle the crank bolt and all that junk. Dog. There it is. Freaking guy. From top dead center to approximately, what would that be, 15 degrees off, and that way when I remove the tensioner, take tension out of the belt, the cams don't jump on me. So that's what's going on here. That's what the T mark is for on the top there. Time to get out the crankshaft holding tool. There are two holes inside the crankshaft pulley that I've threaded. And the threads get pretty beat up over the years, so I'm cleaning them out with a tap. And they're an M8 by 1.25 thread pitch. So that's that, and then the crank tool I'll be using, this guy right here, two bolts, M8 1.25 thread pitch. And you want to be careful not to go into the plastic behind it. So once you can see some threads emerging from the other side, should be good to pull it back. So at this point, the only thing to do here is find that hole. And make sure that you can actually get that bolt in there. Bingo. For my family, show me how life moved my darkness, said it'd get better. That's probably where I should have put a helmet in. I crashed my car cause I want to get carried away. These things are usually stuck on here pretty good. This is just a Harbor Freight 3-jaw puller. Came in a set of 4. Nice.
Don't hit your radiator.
They're two 12 millimeter bolts that come up through right next to the tensioner pulley. And I found it easiest just to use the box end, whatever, box end wrench 12 millimeter. I tried it with a socket and that did not go very well. This is extremely important. You want to make sure that you put this back in. You have to remove it to get the water pump out. They call this the mouse door. Water pump is out.
gross.
Well, you get the idea.
Right.
So basically, at this point, I've removed everything out of here. Old water pump, gasket, tensioner, number one idler pulley, number two idler pulley, and belt. I'm not going to be replacing the cam seals or the crank seal. Where are they? They're somewhere in there. But basically, I'm not going to be replacing those because it's not leaking, so better not to mess with it. Then new fan bracket, new idler pulley for the serpentine belt, and new tensioner assembly. It's just about as much money to buy the entire assembly as it is to buy just the pulley itself, so that's why I went with that. There are part numbers if you're into that. I'll have everything, you know, down there for you. But then in the ASIN kit, you've got everything you need for belt, tensioner, the two pulleys, sticker, and gasket. And there should be, yeah, let's see, that includes the little rubber gasket that I just pulled off of the back of the water pump right there. So that's pretty nice there. So now it's time to reassemble. Mouse door in. Threads. There's a white dot on the crank pulley, and it looks like there's a threaded hole, so you can pull it off with the special service tool. And there are two tick marks on the actual belt in white. That's what you're looking at on the bottom here. And then next I'm gonna work my way to the left-hand cam on that side of the engine. Line up the water pump, slip the belt over the right-hand cam, and then it should slide over the number one idler pulley. You can see at the moment that the belt is actually off by a tooth. So I'm gonna have to stretch it from the bottom back around and figure that out. There you go. The easiest way to get this side on, down here I've actually slipped the belt off of the number one idler pulley, which again is the right hand one, the one with black that pivots. And while I'm keeping tension here in the center on the water pump to make sure that the left-hand pulley doesn't slip, I'm gonna use a 17 millimeter wrench just to turn this cam just enough, and it just slipped on. So, now that this is aligned, that's on there perfectly. Double check that this one still is, and it is. So now the important part, which is to make sure that the belt does not slip on anything. Boom, just like that. Here's the tensioner and the two bolts that I cleaned up. Make sure you don't pull out that pin until it's in place.
Look pretty. You stay here in my way of fear.
There's one. And there's the other. Now, before you remove that pin out of the tensioner, it is a great idea to make sure that all your marks still line up. So, I'm gonna do that real quick. Looks good up top for both of them. I'll check more. And that one is still correct. Harder to see, but there it is. There we go.
Sure.
top dead. It's true top dead.
See how there's a little thingy right here?
little thing. Yep.
Yeah, I don't know what. I think there's a name for it. It's some kind of safety valve. Thermostat, brand new, and Lexus gasket. If you hold the serpentine belt in this configuration and shove it down in here, you can get it on without actually having to remove, well, really anything. Pushing down on the tensioner, just like that.